So in today's video, I'll be sharing the recipe of mohura. As you can see in my video, it's a completely different recipe, one among the 56 items that is offered to Lord Jagannath in the Puri Dham. And as I said, I had already shared a previous video on one of the recipes, that was besara. This is my second recipe in the Mahaprasad series. Stay tuned for this recipe of mohura or mixed veg from the temple land of Puri. Hey guys, I am Subhankari and I welcome you all to my channel Su's Food Corner. I hope you all are doing great in your lives, and if you are new to my page, do subscribe to my page and do not forget to tap the bell button. And thank you all for loving my channel so much and liking my videos so much. Let's begin with this lovely recipe. Here I have taken some vegetables that are locally available in the state of Orissa or in Puri, because the temple, the tradition is very ancient, and in those days the local vegetables were included. So pumpkin, I have taken diced pumpkin around half a cup with skin. And here I have taken long beans cut around half a cup, little bit larger size I have cut. Spine gout diced I have taken half a cup, pointed gout diced I have taken here half a cup. All these vegetables have nicely been washed and cut. And here I have some yam diced 1/4 cup, white radish diced 1/4 cup, and arum diced around 1/4 cup. These are all the root vegetables. You can also use some sweet potato. And some raw banana I have taken in half a cup. I have soaked them in turmeric water so that they don't turn black due to oxidization. And here I have taken here nadi vadi. It's commonly found in the states of Odisha. Otherwise, we can take white gram vadi that are always available, around half a cup. And I have here taken the black gram. I have soaked them overnight around half a cup. This will give the essence of mohura, which separates it from besara, the other mixed veg item. And here I have taken some spices. Here I have fennel seeds around 2 tablespoons, coriander seeds around 1 tablespoon, cumin seeds I have taken here around 1 tablespoon, cinnamon stick I have taken here 1 inch, black peppercorns 1 tablespoon, and 4 to 5 I have taken here green cardamom and 4 to 5 cloves. All these are the spices that give the aroma of this recipe. And here I have taken ginger around 1 inch, bay leaf 1, acetifatata or hing around 1/2 teaspoon, and for tempering I have taken here black mustard seeds 1/2 teaspoon and cumin seeds 1/2 teaspoon, and turmeric powder 1 teaspoon also will be included, and salt to taste. And apart from that, I have here raw fresh grated coconut around 1/2 cup, and jaggery or gourd around 3 teaspoon, or you can increase the amount. And here I have taken clarified butter or desi ghee around 5 to 6 tablespoon. So the first process begins is we need to rock grind our spices. So I had soaked them for around 10 minutes, and then I'll add all the spices here, the seeds and the bay leaves and ginger. So initially I'll just crush the ginger so that this can be grinded nicely. Here I have tried to show the traditional way that is used in temple. Nothing can match the taste and the essence of the temple food that is offered to Lord Jagannath in the among 56 items that is served. But here just I am trying to show the way of baking mohura, because millions visit this temple and they have tasted that. So if you want, you can try this. This is a traditional way. You can always use the grinding machine as you can wish, but I have showed the most traditional way, that is rock grinding using a stone grinder. Here I have just grinded it once. I have not made a smooth paste. You can actually feel it. So for mohura or mixed veg, the spice paste should be of this consistency. So this is it. Now I'll take this out in an earthen plate. And I have, as I said, I have tried my best to use all the authentic ways. So this is it. Prepare this mohura or mixed veg. I have taken an earthen cookware here. I'll place it on gas stove on medium high flame. But in temple, traditionally, it's done on wood fire. So once this earthen pot is heated, I have added around 3 tablespoons of clarified butter, and water I'll add around 1 glass. So, and then first I'll add the jana or the black gram and wait for around 10 minutes till it starts to boil. And once it starts to boil, I let it boil for around 5 to 6 minutes, and after 5 to 6 minutes I'll add all the vegetables. As I had already said in my previous recipe of Mahaprasad besara, in temple देर इज द शियर मैजिक दैट हैपेंस. नथिंग इज स्टर्ड, नथिंग इज कवर्ड, येट द फूड इज कुक टू परफेक्शन. सो ऑल दैट हैपेंस बिकॉज ऑफ द ग्रेस ऑफ लॉर्ड जगन्नाथ. इन माई वीडियो आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू रिक्रिएट द एसेंस एंड After adding all the vegetables, I'll add some salt and the spice paste that we had made that goes in. You can at this stage add turmeric powder around 1/2 teaspoon and water. I'll add more 1 glass and then very carefully I'll hold the pot from sides and give it a mix. If you want, you can use spatula, but I have not used spatula in the entire recipe. Neither I'll cover it. After 10 minutes, you can see the vegetables have nicely softened and reduced in size, and it has also released some water. Let it cook for more 10 minutes. After 20 minutes, the vegetables have changed color. At this stage, I'll add grated coconut and jaggery. I'll add according to taste. I have added around 4 teaspoons. You can adjust it according to your choice. And then the vadi or nadi vadi that goes in. This is a special type of vadi that is used in the state of Odisha. As I said, if it's not available, you can use the normal urad dal vadi that is available. Give it a mix and again leave for around more 10 minutes. Total, it took me around 25 to 30 minutes, and after 25 minutes it's almost done. It's done. I'll switch off the flame. I'll add the aseti patata or hing, mustard and cumin seeds goes in. I've heated some clarified butter or ghee and the tempering goes on top. As I'm making a video, I have just covered it and I'll leave for around 30 minutes because it's a earthenware, so that is the resting time. The earthen cookware will retain all the heat. After half an hour, I'll just give it a mix, and my mohura or mixed veg, a different style of mixed veg, is ready. Two types of mixed veg I prepared. One is besara with mustard seeds and the second one is this mohura, and this is ready. I just can't explain the aroma. And now I'll serve this in an earthen plate. So here I've served my mohura. You can see how perfectly it's done. We have cooked in an earthen pot. I had not used a spatula, but yes, you can always use the spatula. But as I had done this video, I wanted to show the classical way, so I had not used it. And lastly, some grated coconut, and to offer this to Lord Jagannath, basil leaf or tulsi leaf. So this has now become prasad. Nothing is offered to Lord Jagannath without a tulsi leaf. So this is mohura or mixed veg, one of the prasad among the 56 offerings that are offered to Lord Jagannath in Puri Dham. I have tried my best to show you the most authentic way. I hope you will try this recipe and let me know your feedback. And now it's time for comment of the day. Today's comment of the day is from Grace Claire. She writes, "Wow, amazing recipe. You are so talented. I can't wait to try it out." Thank you so much, Grace, for such lovely words. I hope you will try the biryani recipe of mine. Thank you for all your love and support. And today's recipe, as I said, holds a very special place in my heart. I have used stone grinder and not used spatula. You can use the normal grinder and even can use spatula and can make a normal cookware also, but the process is same. And this, as I said, is thus the way to express my devotion. And if you have liked today's video, do give a thumbs up, share with your family and friends, and do not forget to subscribe to my page. See you in next video. Till then, stay safe, love life and happy fooding.